joining me from Predictive Discoveries, Paul Roberts. Paul, nice to see you. How are you?
Very well, thank you, Andrew. Nice to see you too.
Good to hear, Paul. Look, you've had some RC results out from recent drilling at Kaninko. Give us an update. How's it looking?
Right. So this is part of a large program of diamond drilling. So it's the first 12 holes. And what it's demonstrated to us in areas where we hadn't drilled before, that we're getting the zone of mineralization that we saw in the air core, which caused all of the excitement in Predictive, is persisting on the other line. So we're seeing a zone which is, you know, in the range of 100 to 200 meters wide. And within that, we got some pretty impressive results. The best intercept was 99 meters of 1.17 grams a ton, and that stopped mineralization. A few of the holes stopped mineralization, and that also was quite useful for us because the drilling has now gone down into the interface between weathered rock and fresh rock, and down there we're still getting values. And that's, of course, quite important because to get the really large tonnages that we're all hoping for here, we need to see mineralization not only in the oxide, where we've been doing nearly all of our drilling so far, that is the air core and this new RC, we also want to see mineralization down in the fresh rock, and we're just starting to penetrate the fresh rock now, and we're seeing gold down there. So we're pretty happy with that.
So you're continuing to drill here, Paul. Give us a snapshot of what's happening at the moment.
Well, for a start, we're waiting for an awful lot of results. So there's a little under 5,000 samples sitting in the lab, split between reverse circulation and diamond drilling. And power auger. The diamond drilling is the first five holes of diamond drilling, just under 1,000 meters, and that's really important because it's our first good look at what's going on in fresh rock beneath the oxide zone, where all of our or nearly all of our drilling has been. And that diamond drilling will, and those results and the new results that are coming, because of course the diamond drilling continues, will give us an idea of the gold, the kind of gold grades we might expect in the fresh rock, but also the orientation of the mineralization, which will help guide future drilling on this project. So that's important. And then we're also waiting for results for the RC. Now, we haven't completed coverage of the mineralized zone, but we've got a mineralized footprint defined by power auger drilling, which is now extended to 1.3 kilometers long, and we're doing systematic coverage of that with the RC. So we're looking forward to those results. And then we've also got a large number of power auger samples and more to come to the laboratory, which are exploring to extend the footprint of mineralization in the oxide in the shallow subsurface. And so that's going on as well. So there's a lot of activity going on. We've got drill rigs still turning, and we've got a lot of results to wait for. And we're expecting those results to come through to us, over the next month or two. And so obviously there'll be a lot of news flow to come out of the project.
So you feel as though you're getting a better understanding of this Northeast Bankan gold zone here, do you?
Yeah, we are getting a better understanding, but there's still a way to go. I mean, we have only released 12 RC holes. The diamond drill rig samples will be obviously very important, but actually getting more comprehensive coverage will give us a clearer idea of what we've got here. But certainly, little by little, we're getting a better idea. We have some idea of the geology, but we really need to connect geology to gold grade, and that's, of course, the process that we're going through right now.
Have you got much to update us on, Paul, as far as some of your other projects in the portfolio?
So within Guinea, we are waiting for some drill results, a limited number of drill results from the Kankan project, which is about 80 kilometres to the east. So we're looking forward to that. Up on Kundian, which is further to the east still, sort of east-northeast of the Kaninko project, we are doing some work, so we're doing geochemical work, some geophysical work. It's a relatively early stage, relatively low cost, but we're looking forward to the results from there. And then stepping outside of Guinea, over in Côte d'Ivoire, of course, we have the joint venture with Resolute Mining. Resolute are currently drilling with the two drill rigs, a power auger drill rig and an air core drill rig, on the Bundiali project. Bundiali, there is a discovery there already. It's what we call it, the Nyungbui discovery. We're exploring a further strike length, at least 4 kilometres we're covering. And obviously, we're hoping that we're going to extend that zone of mineralisation through that work. So we're looking forward to that.
And what's your view, just Paul, while I've got you, on the continued strength in the gold price? Must be encouraging.
Well, it is encouraging. I mean, I would have thought, and of course, most people make mistakes when they try and predict the gold price, but I would have thought if there's any time which is favourable for the gold price, it's right now. And that, of course, is because of the great economic difficulty globally, the difficulty that clearly it's very difficult to get significant income out of bank interest and so on. There's obviously a lot of depressed sectors. This is all a perfect storm for gold, and we see gold rising, and you know, there is a general consensus that gold's going to continue to rise, and given that there is going to be no short-term fix for the coronavirus problem, and the economic damage is obviously going to roll on for significantly longer, you know, we certainly believe that the gold price is going to be very strong for the next few years.
Great to see you, Paul. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Andrew. It's a pleasure.